I remember being at one of my kids' friends' birthday parties, and they were getting to that point where they blow out the candles on the cake. In the interest of sharing pointless trivia, I whispered to the parent next to me that after the kiddie blows on the cake, it will have 1400% more bacteria on it. I thought it was quirky and a hilarious fact, but he seemed genuinely horrified and questioned me in detail about whether it was really true and would the kids get sick. He may even have told a few of the other parents. So this is not only a story of why I don't eat birthday cake, but why I'm not really allowed to go to birthday parties anymore. But it is true. This is the paper published in 2017. It showed that compared to a cake that didn't have the candles blown out, cakes that did have 15 times more bacteria on it. It's difficult to know what to make of this, but 15 times more of anything sounds like a lot. Of course, this is obviously not a public health threat. Our bodies can handle a few extra bugs on our icing with ease, but it is a little unnerving, especially if you constantly feel like your child is coming down with something. Also, when you compound the effects at a birthday party, think of the shared crisps and nuts in a bowl or the shared drinks, let alone the close proximity. And kids are terrible at personal boundaries and washing their hands, or just washing, period. In reality, this cake-based increased exposure to bacteria and microorganisms is minuscule compared to what we encounter every day, every breath, every handle or surface or human we touch. If you think birthday cakes have it bad, think about the laptop or keyboard or phone that you're in front of right now. Studies at the University of Arizona show that the average desktop keyboard has 400 times more bacteria than the average toilet seat. And this gets even higher if you share your computer. Phones can be even worse. We touch and use them even more, about 50 times a day. And you probably don't take your laptop into the loo, but every now and again, you may take your phone. When you flush the toilet, bacteria gets spread everywhere, which is how phones often end up with nasty poo bacteria on them. To be fair though, when it comes to the cake, the phone, and the computer, most of these bugs are common bugs found on our skin, in our mouths, and in our nasal passages, and most are completely harmless. If you're well, it probably won't bother you, but if you're unwell, or your immune system is off, or slightly depressed, or even if you have cuts on your hands, they can all actually cause infections. I guess the bottom line here is stay hygienic, and the line for hygiene is actually different for everyone. We've all gotten better at washing our hands and using hand gel, but sometimes we forget the other obvious places where bacteria thrive, like our phones and keyboards, and sometimes even birthday cake. Here are a few simple tips to keep them sanitary. Once a week or month, turn your keyboard upside down and empty the debris from the keys, and maybe even use a can of compressed air to blow out all the sandwich crumbs. You may be surprised what's lurking in there. If you're in DIY mode, then you can run the sticky side of a post-it note along the keys to dislodge the bits and crumbs. And maybe even use a Q-tip to clean between the keys if it's visibly grotty. And finally, wipe it down with a cloth. All this really helps with the bacterial load, and it takes less than a minute, and it should be part of our workspace zen routine. If you're super keen, you could get one of these, a dishwashable keyboard. Yep, you heard me right. When it comes to your phone, wiping it down with a cloth helps, but using a 50-50 water and rubbing alcohol mix works even better, and once a month is fine. Generally speaking though, simple hand washing is the best bet to stop those nasty bacteria from spreading to others and yourself. We don't live, work, or go to birthday parties in a sterile environment. There is a risk to catching dangerous bugs. Our best defense is hand washing. See the link below on how to do this properly. It's slightly more complicated than you may think. Getting back to the topic at hand, why I don't eat birthday cake. Well, actually I do, I just don't eat it if a little child's blown all over it. And the best way to prevent this? Sparklers. Thanks for watching. Till next time, stay healthy.